Microsoft Project, specifically Project for the Web and its Teams companion app, are built on the tried and tested scheduling engine from the Project desktop client. It offers a visually rich and intuitive work management experience that highlights progress and exceptions in the schedule. Each task contains a wealth of information, including the context of its summary task, which team members are assigned to work on it, any labels that we may have applied, a detailed description of the work, start, finish duration, percent complete, as well as the ability to organize the work into customizable buckets and setting the priority for each task. If you are managing an agile project, tasks can be added to the backlog or moved to individual sprints. You can add a detailed checklist to define and track progress at a more granular level inside the task. Then there's completed effort, remaining effort, and total effort. If you add any custom fields to your project, these will also show up here. On the right, we have the dependencies and attachments. These attachments can reference the team files in your SharePoint document library, as you would expect. When managing tasks inside of Microsoft Teams, you get the added benefit of group chats and conversations, both within individual tasks and also at the project level, including at mentions to get your team members' attention. The board view groups tasks into categories on an interactive board. The first one here shows the buckets that the project team has defined. You can color code each bucket and drag and drop tasks between them. The next board shows which team members' tasks have been assigned to and those tasks that are still unassigned. It is easy to filter for specific tasks in all of these views. For example, we can filter tasks that are running late, or perhaps the tasks that have been labeled as testing. Other boards include progress, finish date, labels, priority, and sprint. The timeline is great for a more visual view of the project. It is very interactive. When we mouse over a task, it highlights the dates at the top. We can drag a task to move the dates, extend the duration of a task, and create dependencies by dragging to connect. Marking a task complete here gives us that very satisfying. In addition to exporting the schedule to Excel, the timeline can also be exported to a PDF file for easy sharing. The built-in charts provide good high-level information about the tasks of the project. They are focused on status buckets and effort per person. To highlight the data, simply mouse over the legend to see which tasks are not started, in progress, late, and completed. The people view shows all the tasks by who they are assigned to, including incomplete and completed tasks, and grouped by the color-coded buckets. The summary at the top shows each team member's workload, either as a count of tasks or in hours. When switching off compact mode, we can see the richness of the tasks. Again, the filter comes in very handy here. The critical path filter allows us to quickly identify which team members are working on tasks that are on the critical path for the project. Project for the Web in Teams gives you access to more advanced project management tools in a collaborative environment. Features like custom columns, people view, and sprints support a diverse set of project management needs. Try it for free today by following the link in the description.